Attorney General Sessions announces the new crackdown on leaks from the White House. Joining us now, John Bolton, former U.S. Ambassador to the United Nations. Mr. Ambassador, I don't see how you can conduct foreign policy if the President's conversations with foreign leaders are splashed across the front of the New York Post. That's outrageous and wrong.
Absolutely, and it is a breach of national security. These transcripts were classified, and properly so. One of the reasons you give information a classification is the threat to American national security if it becomes public. And if foreign leaders don't think that they can have a conversation with the president in confidence, we are very badly damaged. I think this goes back to Bradley Manning leaking tens of thousands of State Department cables. We've seen other examples through WikiLeaks as well. This is not just transparency and opening the government up for public scrutiny. It is a real damage to our ability to conduct American foreign and national security policy.
What do you do? It seems like there is a cabal within the federal bureaucracy, whether it's the Justice Department or the State Department or wheresoever, there is a cabal which really wants to stop and resist anything from President Trump. There seems to be large numbers of these people doing this. I don't see what you can do about it, frankly.
Well, you know, over the years, there have been a lot of efforts to find the sources of leaks, to curtail them and whatnot. I think some things that could be considered going forward anyway would include polygraphing State Department and White House personnel. This is standard practice in the intelligence community. It may sound offensive, but these people have extremely important jobs, and I think polygraphing them may be one prophylactic measure you can take. In terms of the leaks that have already occurred, I think these transcripts of the conversations the president had with other foreign leaders may be something worth focusing on for this reason. It is possible that the Washington Post had these transcripts back from the time roughly when the conversations occurred, but I don't think so, because I think the pressure to publish something like this before somebody else publishes it would induce a media outlet to put it in as soon as they get it. So I think that means the odds favor the argument, although it's not certain, that the leaks of these transcripts were relatively recent. So I'd go in with a full-scale investigation. I wouldn't worry about the thousands of other leaks for the moment. I'd focus on these and see if we could find some possibility of getting to the people who actually leaked it. And
okay.
I think that alone, that focus, could create some discipline for others as well.
20 seconds. I think the Washington Post is a disgrace for putting this in their newspaper. And you say?
Well, I think that's typical of the mainstream media. Look, there was a time, if you go back to World War II, the media actually supported America winning the war.
Right.
They're neutral now. They're neutral on things like this. I think that's a mistake.
No, a mistake? I think it's a disgrace. Ambassador Bolton, thanks for joining us, sir. We appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you, Stuart.